Okay, so our budget is $6. So do we know these Honeycrisp apples are $1.50? I'm gonna get one, okay? Because I believe I should get one. Okay, so we know we can cook food when we're going. So we want to look for something that's pre-packaged already that has multiple things in it. At least that's ours that's cheaper than that. Okay, so anyway, I'm not gonna spin them off the Uber, it's good. I'm not gonna spin them off. So they got vegan mac already. Yeah, they got chicken, ginger, meat, and soup. I wouldn't eat nothing like that. They got a lentil soup that I can eat on. But I wouldn't eat the whole thing. You know that. Okay, I can see if it's vegan. I should have thought right now. Let me see. So this would be something good, quick. Like I said, $3.50, so I can use that. But we're going to wait. Because I could use something else, too. So the goal for me is to make at least 2 meals out of one. I said, but I don't forget that I can cook, so because that's an expensive apple. I can always get a Granny Smith because that's always my alternative. So it's one wonder bag. It's like I can even get a bag or like something like that and then cook it up for the next 2 days.
Yeah.
Let me see. I'm gonna go into the soup aisle. Okay, we got some tomatoes. I'm not working with like a dollar on my card yet. I don't like it, they don't take the dollar, but they pay how much you got to pay. I could make me a nice little here. I said, I ain't bring none of my groceries. I said, that would have been a perfect place to bring my groceries there. Because I really wouldn't be cooking without any of that. I said, I can always get there and you speak to there on $1.99. I can get two of these or one. So I always think of stuff like that, especially when you live in a place where you can pretty much make your own food, yeah. And you don't want to put a bunch of condiments, but you also don't want to cook. I can always buy one of these big ass things with squat butter on squat soup and then get some bread. Ooh, I might do that, dude. I think I might do that. Get some butternut squash soup, get some bread, and then like soak it in there. Yeah. Timmy corn and roasted pepper soup. Black style black bean soup. That black bean soup looks kind of good. Latin style black bean soup. If I can get that, it's vegan. Okay, we got this gluten free, low sodium, butternut squash soup. So this one's got something, it's $3. Y'all want butternut squash or black bean? I see, I'm probably going with this butternut squash. Let me get that. Ooh, garden vegetable soup is pretty good too. That's a small lentil soup. This $1.99, $2.99. It's vegan. Lentil soup. They got a vegetable soup. Okay, they got a bone broth. I heard that Mexican. Really nice. Alright, so this is what I got. If I was gangsta, I can get some milk and have that for the morning. But I said, I'll be on the tea. One day meals, yeah. One day meals. I should have bought some tea. I said, I might not get this out. I gotta get some bread. So I do need some fruit. Yeah. Anyway, okay, hold on. I'll talk to y'all later.
It's actually Recall Creighton. I don't have an intro for myself yet, but I wanted to give you guys an update. I know I started in the grocery store, but then I was like, I'm getting fresh. I wasn't even high, you guys, but I did want to tell you guys I always try to find a Trader Joe's where I am traveling at. It's my first time in Santa Monica, but anytime, really just honestly, like, being in the physical of California. Like, I've drove through, had to roll through, but I actually never actually went through. But I actually want to tell you guys, like, I like to look for places that are really convenient for being able to, you know, make my food, prepare my food, but also prepare, you know, and store anything that I do bring on the road, because I do like to not really eat out as much, you know, because that's where my skin, you know, usually suffers at, when I have to use, you know, compromise my alternatives. So, you guys, this is the F part of my series, but this is just, you know, for the flying and finances, but also food, okay? So, I like to keep that triple F, just, you know, pretty much apparently. Okay, so I have some bread. I got a mini baguette. So this was like $1.79, which I think is really good because you can eat on bread. It keeps you more full. And I can also like bring in my alternative butter, stuff to top. I always try to move or, you know, be in the vicinity of a grocery store because I love to walk. And I already got in 5 miles today. Well, it's 4:50, but. And I got some butternut squash soup. Of course, I like to make this on my homemade, but because I'm not the type right now to bring a full on blender anywhere with me yet, unless I do this full time, which we're considering, but we'll see. So we got the butternut squash soup. Okay, so that right there lasts for 17 days. So of course I can do that, but I can also put it in, like, you know, but they have utensils down there for me to cook. So I'll do a little cooking vlog later. Obviously on my story. Okay, so it's gonna be unreal. So you guys can follow me over there. But yes, I got that so we can have some of this. And because I know this is probably, it's seasoned, but probably not seasoned super well. That's seen it had like sugar, a little bit of salt, garlic powder, ginger powder, et cetera, et cetera. But I decided to, I had saw another grocery store. So I went to Trader Joe's, I got the baguette. I got like a fruit snack, which is like 50 cents. And I got this, so I only spent like, it was, I know my total was $7.25, okay? But I had like did something else, okay. And I also got a Honeycrisp apple, so that would cost me the most, but I will always spend that bang for this honey and this apple, okay. So that was $1.50 off rip, and then I ended up going to another grocery store and getting a Tangelo, or a Manolo, however you guys want to pronounce that one. It's a Tangelo. So then I got some seasoning, but this is only $1, so I feel like I'll probably get like a little shaker and keep this in there, and this will be my travel herb. But I'm also gonna make my own herbal mix, that way I can, you know, kind of move with that when I'm traveling and food like that. But yeah, this is pretty much it. I love this. So I got the red pepper flakes, and this is always really good to top it on top. I would love to like eat it with some sour cream or whatever, but and cheese, but I didn't want to be the one to tote that around. So that is a, you know, pretty easy meal for me on the road, because I can pretty much, I'm not gonna eat this in one setting. So this is about 2, 3, 4 meals really honestly for me. I'm gonna aim to make it 2 or 3 meals, because of course I want to eat later. But that's gonna be pretty much my meal. So $7.25. I can eat this. I can eat a half an apple for today, or half an apple now, or eat it as of right now as a full blown meal. Cause sometimes I'll be able to get my water percentages in here. So that will really make me excited. And then we also have the orange, which is another form of water percentage as well. So I bought 2 water bottles. I bought a water bottle yesterday. I bought one of these just now. That's gonna be for later. I keep that in the room with me. They don't have many fridges in here, but I don't mind because I'm going to leave my water in there. I don't need to put this in the fridge in a public space, so that's fine. Yesterday, I ended up buying a large pizza for $8, which is super, like, I felt like was really smart. And I got 3 meals out of it, okay? So, I mean, yesterday, I ate basically half the freaking pizza. I was so hungry, but I probably had a little bit of munchies because I had edible. So, I went there, got that. It was from Domino's. I got thin crust. So, I did compromise on the cheese, but I got thin crust. What else? Thin crust, spinach, red pepper. So I got my red pepper with my vitamin C, you know, whatever else I eat. And then I got spinach, red pepper, and jalapenos on it, okay? But of course, next time I recommend getting mushrooms on it if you wanted to, you know, split up the alternatives for the veggie vegetables, okay? Or mushrooms, black olives, and spinach would be really a good combo. I can only eat olives on a pizza, but whatever. So that's pretty much what I got. So that'll be able to stay in the room with me. I'm gonna probably go eat some. I really can't wait to dip the bread and eat like that. So that was that. So my total was $7.25 at the grocery store. And physical cash, I only spent $2.14. Because you guys know I travel with my food stamp card, just because I feel like it's really convenient for me not to use that as a business expense, because I use it for pleasure and investments like this, you know. So I can always do this as a thing without, you know, being a scammer, I guess. Okay, so we got this. I went to Smart and Final, which is not too far from me. I got the orange from there, and I got the seasoning packet from there. So, you know, Trader Joe's ain't carrying like that. But I did forget my hair. I thought I brought mine. You know how I travel with my little coconut packets? I thought I had that because I really need it for the beach, but that's neither here nor there. But pretty much, I need to go back and get that, but I'm just gonna go buy some oil from the closer store. So September 7-Eleven, I got the waters. And then I get me, like, if I wanted something to drink, I'll get a big old, pretty much these The man yesterday gave me this. So this had vitamin water in it. So I'm still drinking on that. I didn't put no ice in it so it doesn't like get nasty. And then this is the Jamaica juice. And this one I'm drinking on pretty much right now. And that is how I drink liquids. But also, spent under $20. Okay, so I just spent under $20 on food for the last three days. We'll say 3 days. Because before, I literally went out to eat. I spent $20 there at the Goddess shop. So I had anybody in like a breakfast and like some juice. That was when I first got into Chicago. So that's the total so far. So we did $20 at the Goddess place in Chicago. And then when we got here, we spent another 20. I went to Dunkin' Donuts. So I spent $2 there. Then I spent another 20. I spent 14 at I have it on my story, but it's like some type of Asian restaurant. So I got some miso soup and then I tried octopus. I didn't really like it. I couldn't see myself eating again. It was too chewy. But then I got some like potato cakes or something like that, some fritters or some shit like that. And then, so that was 14 plus the two. So that's Dunkin' Donuts plus that place. So that's $16. And then of course I clued in total. Okay. Then it didn't cost that much. And then we go into the next, I end up spending like $20 at Starbucks too. Cause I end up getting two breakfast things. I get the egg white bites. And then I end up getting like a impossible sandwich. So I never end up getting pretty much an impossible sandwich at the other place too. So I'm going to go ahead and talk about the herbs. I did a little intro on my story about the herbs I tried. So this is my second time being here. It's a very much close and walking distance. And they have pretty much all prices. So I'm pretty much geeked about that. I wish they gave me a little top handle bag, but I guess I'm getting them like enough. But this time I was only able to get pre-rolls. So just because I wanted a flower, but they do a subcharge and I only had a certain amount on my card that I wanted to spend at that specific store because I knew I had to go to the grocery store. But you know, I put a more bigger budget on my groceries than I would on my herb. But this is part of my diet, so I consider it as I consider it the flower of the F word. Alright, so we got the herbs. So this is my second time being here. Like I said, I spent $27 at the other store, so you get $3, you get like a couple dollars back. It's like a surcharge, so you really, I didn't spend that much. So I spent like $25 the first time, and then I did get something, and I got some pre-rolls in Chicago, so that was only $10 as well. It was $15 with my discount, and then this one I got a discount at the last store, that's why it only cost that much as well. And this time I actually only spent I spent $19, but they gave me my change back, so I only spent like $15. So yeah, so I spent $15 here. Well, I spent $15 here at Herba this time. So I got three pre-rolls. I'm just gonna actually break this down and use it with my herbs because that's what I really want to do. But I think I'm gonna actually take some pictures today. I'm gonna go out and get some photos, and then kind of pick these up, and I'm gonna do mine. So let me show you guys. Okay, I think I'm mix it with mugwort. And then we got some peppermint. I know I brought some peppermint with these. So with these, I'm just gonna put them together like that. So this is how you guys will be able to order them as well when I start. I'm gonna come back here and make a really large purchase. You guys will be able to pretty much have these, okay? With my little dice, et cetera, et cetera. I say, okay, I made a bunch of rule today. So this is how I want to do it, but I end up getting the lamb's bread, which is sativa. I got strawberry sorbet, which is sativa, and then I got black cherry soda, which is dominant indica, okay? So this is how they are come in. I'm just pretty much doing product sampling. And then now that I'm doing those samples, I have these. So I was going to, like I said, I wanted a flower. I wanted to be able to roll it up. But I said, I don't actually see myself, unless I get my own cute little jars, I don't really see myself flowering it up. I just feel like these pre-rolls are a lot more trustable. I mean, you know, you guys, I don't have to do all the packaging. And well, that's because I'm trying to avoid the packaging, pretty much. I'm trying to avoid the, like, label part of it. I don't know why, I just don't like making those. But I don't mind. I just, we'll have to see, okay? But this is what I like. and that's that, okay? Love you guys. I'll see you guys in the next vlog. I hope this was the first part of my FFF. So I got the finances, I got the fitness out of the way, because you guys know I walked 5 miles in total. So it was like a 2 hour, I say about an hour and 30 minute walk in combination, okay? So I'll post that at the end, but I have that on my plant baby nom. And this week you guys can go get more details about the herbs, because I'll be posting that over there and doing reviews over there, okay? So I love you guys, and I can't wait to see you guys shop my shop. Ciao, bolas.